Good evening, this is Ash, and welcome to another model train review video. Tonight I'm going to review something rather special, and this is the Heljan Class 52 Western, and in particular this model is D1036, named as Western Emperor. And if we just turn the box around, there's the reference number of 5210, and there's the information below of D1036 Emperor. As you may know, Heljan make a superb range of locomotives, although there has been a couple of glitches with a couple of classes, like the Clayton for example. But overall, I find their models very impressive. Now, upon removing the foam tray, which I do admit that you get loads of padding and protection for the model in the box, as Heljan tend to use foam on their Class 52s, although they have started using the ice cube packaging like on my Class 23. The model is also protected in a polythene bag as well. So if we just remove the bag, being very careful not to dislodge any of the detail parts that have been fitted. And upon removing the model, once we get the packaging out of the way, you may have noticed that the metal silver footsteps have been added as well. I haven't bothered to fit any of the brake rods because the first reason, they are too fragile, and the second reason, they can hinder cornering on R607s and R609 curved track, which is made by Hornby. But what I will do, I will place it on the track in a moment and I will set up the test track for a test drive. But likewise, you do get a nice amount of weight. The model does have working head codes, but no tail lights. But you have got some grab rails there on the front. D1036 on the side. You've also got some handrails. The driver's window partition is open on this model, which is on the driver's side, as where on the second man's side, the window's in the closed position. Excuse me. And also, if I just move my thumb out of the way, there's a printed nameplate of Western Emperor, although I do intend getting some etched nameplates to place over the top of these printed ones. But I do like the livery, and the BR green is very, very nice on a Western. I would kind of call this green racing green. But now that we have attached the, well, placed the model onto the test track, should I say, I'm going to swiftly hook up the rest of the test track. And then I shall lower the camera after positioning the model into the correct position. Then I shall give you all some close-ups. So we'll just lower the camera first. There we go. And carefully drive the beast into the correct position. There we go. It's pretty much a brand new locomotive, although the detailing parts have been added to the best of my ability, like the footsteps. As like I've previously mentioned, the brake rods are just too fragile. But I'm sure that you will agree that this is an absolute stunning model. And I do like the racing green as well. Now let's zoom in on the front. As you can see, the buffer beam has been detailed with the cosmetic screw link coupler and the brake pipes, complete with the head code of 1A08. Of course, 8 is one of my lucky numbers. You've also got a handrail on the front. The window wipers have also been added as well. And I have to say, stunning work yet again, thanks to Heljan. I do hear rumours that Dapol are supposed to be bringing out a model of one of these Class 52s this year, but it will be interesting to compare the two, as I do hear it's supposed to be a superbly detailed model. But sticking with this one, here is a close-up of the Western Emperor nameplate, although it is printed rather than etched, which is a shame, as etched nameplates would really look stunning on this model. Now, if we just zoom in on the trucks, you'll also see there's a set of metal steps just going out into 8x zoom. This time the camera seems to be playing ball, as when I go into anything more than 8x zoom, everything tends to go blurry. Now, if we just pan the camera up, you can also see the BR logo and the catenary warning sign near the driver's cab door. Just like with the Class 55 Deltic, the Class 52 Westerns have 4 fans on the roof. And I believe, I might be incorrect, I am open to correction on this, I think the Class 52s also had twin engines, or were they just a single engine? But if you know the correct engine formation on the Class 52 Western, please feel free to post a comment and correct me accordingly. But otherwise, sticking with the model, this one also has some footsteps added to this side of the trucks as well. The footsteps are quite easy to fit once you know how to fit them, as they are just precast metal strips that come on a sprue in the box. But the window wipers are quite a nightmare to fit due to the recessed drill holes underneath the ledge just above the windscreen. But anyways, as we've covered enough of this model, I think it's time to give the beast a test drive. So I shall go into reverse. Oops, that's forwards. I have to go into reverse. As it's a brand new locomotive, it will need a run-in time, which I will do later. But just for the benefit of this review, I'll just drive it forwards and backwards on this test track. But like with all Heljan models, this model has a central can motor and all-wheel drive. It is DCC compatible, and if you do wish to fit DCC to this model, you will require an 8-pin DCC decoder. But I do like how quiet this model really is, as most of the noise tends to come from the gearing and the driveline more than the motor. So, Before we come to an end of this review, I will do a couple of more runs and then I will give my final score. Currently using around 30% power. So the model is responding quite nicely to that. Do apologise if you've just seen a moth fly across the camera, as I currently have my window open at the moment, just to let a bit of fresh air in here, due to the modelling glue that I've been using earlier. It does have a strong odour to it, but nonetheless I do hope that you've enjoyed this review. I shall now bring the model to the right position and I shall zoom in and give my final score. Now, to be fair to Heljan, the only criticisms I have about this model is that the brake rods are really too fragile to be fitted onto the model, unless you've got a very steady hand and lots of patience. But other than that, I have no faults about the Heljan model at all. In my opinion, it does seem to capture the shape of the real life Class 52 Westerns, and personally I think Heljan's done a great job on this model of the Class 52 Western. So, although some may disagree, but to me the model does feel right for a Class 52. But anyways, here is my final score of 10 out of 10, as I feel it is a very impressive model, and that concludes my review. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below, and thank you for watching. Stay tuned for another video coming soon, and have a good week.